Good evening and welcome to First Christian Church, Mount Carmel, Illinois. This is our Christmas Eve service, and we would love to welcome you and have you join us tonight. And we pray that this will be a special service that will enhance your Christmas season and your Christmas Eve together with your family. Grateful and thankful that you're joining us tonight, and we hope that you get a blessing from our service. Will you join me as we begin with prayer? Lord, we thank you for all that you give to us. And as we celebrate the birth of your Son Jesus tonight, we pray that the love that was shared from you would, to this world in which we live, would be one that is felt in the hearts throughout the world of all mankind, and allowing a peace that surpasses hate and brings all to a better understanding of goodwill toward one another. As we praise you from our activities, and as we pause from our activities, the season that we are sharing, may it be one that brings in these next few moments a peace that passes all understanding as we worship together and bring together the true meaning of the Christmas season to each of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The lighting of the Advent candles has been a long tradition in the church. And again, we light one more time the Advent wreath. The first candle is the candle of hope. In Isaiah 9, verses 2, 6, and 7, the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned, for unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. The second candle is the candle of love. Isaiah 40:3 through 5 says, "A voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all people will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken." God so loved us that he sent Jesus Christ to reconcile us unto himself. Our third candle is the candle of joy. The joy that was celebrated in the eternal kingdom of God when Jesus was born is shared with everyone tonight. Scriptures in Matthew 2, verses 10 and 11 tell us, "When the wise men saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh." We complete our circle of the outer candles on this Advent wreath by lighting the fourth candle, which represents peace. Hebrews 12, verse 14 says, "Pursue peace with everyone, and the holiness without which no one will see the Lord." The Bible reminds us that Jesus came to bring peace. The angels proclaimed peace. And when we have Jesus in our lives, we have peace. Now in the center of our Advent wreath is the last candle to be lit. It is called the Christ candle and represents purity. The true love of God comes to us in the form of a baby, free from sin and pure to live life before us as one without sin. Let us pray. Father God, thank you for these moments and these remembrances. Thank you for the candles which give an earthly light, but mostly thank you for the candle of Jesus Christ, who came into this world to be the light unto our souls so that we might find our way to you. We ask that you bless us as we remember, bless us as we celebrate, bless us as we love one another. In Jesus' name, amen.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered with, and Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was of the descendant from the house and the lineage of David. Let us reflect as Eli Hawking joins us with his special music. Thank you.
Luke 2 through 7 tells us that he went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Please listen as Sharon shares us about the sweet baby boy.
Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, didn't know. Didn't know you came to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes was blind, we couldn't see. We didn't know who you was.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy to all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign to you, for you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among those whom he favors." Now, let us reflect on these scriptures as Bailey shares with us about the glory of the heavens.
is the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, major lift, the baffled king composing alleluia. 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 Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne. She cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the alleluia. 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 This floor, I used to live alone before I knew you. But I've seen your flag on the marble arch. This love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken alleluia. 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 There was a time when you let me know what's really going on below, but now you never show that to me, do ya? In you, the holy dove was moving too, and every breath you drew was alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us go now into Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. Please be still and listen to Marilyn and Elisa and their song of Away in the Manger. Thank you.
But Mary kept all of these words, and she pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and all they had seen as it had been told them. Mary may have had some questions that pondered in her heart as she pondered these words. Let us listen to Barry Roberts as he shares. Mary, did you know?
This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? And the sleeping child you're holding is the great
is a very, very special time. For it is a time that we end with Advent and we begin the journey with Jesus to the cross. But before he reached the cross, he gathered with his disciples, as hopefully he's gathering with us tonight. And he said to them, not to let our hearts be troubled, not to get excited. He met with them in the upper room as he shared with them, oh, so many secrets, I'm sure, that we do not know. So I'm asking you that as the choir sings, let us prepare our hearts as we together once more share the bread and the cup in remembrance of our reconciling act of Jesus. Thank you.
faithful star, the hope of light, guiding the pilgrim through the night, over the mountain till the break of dawn, the dawn, and into the light of perfect day, it will give out a lovely ray. Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on.
Oh, beautiful star,
beautiful, beautiful star
of Bethlehem,
star of Bethlehem, shine upon us until the glory, glory dawn.
Oh, give us the
light to light the way. Star of Bethlehem, shine on, shine on.
Oh, beautiful star,
beautiful hope
of rest, for the redeemed, the good and blessed, yonder in glory when the crown is won, is won. For Jesus is now the star divine, brighter and brighter.
Mercy and justice, we come to this table anticipating the coming of Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. As we eat this bread of life, center our hearts and minds on the paths of peace, reconciliation, justice, and unity that you would have us follow if we are to walk in his path. In this cup, we recognize that we have been called into a holy and gentle life through the offering of life that Jesus Christ made for us. Help our lives be transformed by the presence of the Christ child, that the peace of the manger may become the peace of the world. Amen.
In the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he gave thanks and he shared with his disciples. And what a special time to share tonight. He gave the bread to them and he said, "Take and eat in remembrance of me."
Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And he gave thanks, as we have given thanks here tonight. And he said, "As often as you drink this, drink it in remembrance of me, as my blood shed for your salvation. Drink, remember." Father God, we thank you for the opportunity to come once again around the communion table to have a breaking of the bread and a drinking of the wine with Jesus one more time. We thank you for his appearance upon earth as a small baby and coming into our lives to live free and clear and wonderful and pulling us along with him all the way. We thank you, Father God, for the Christmas season and all who are enjoying this service. Bless them, everyone, in Jesus' name. Amen.
And no Christmas Eve service would be complete unless we could light our candles and join together in a moment of special music of Silent Night. So we will light our candles for here at our church service from the Christ candle, and we hope that if you have a candle at home, that you will light your candle. And please listen to us and join in if you want to. That's okay. And sing. Let us sing as we listen to Silent Night.